So you've done your research and you know that foam insulation is your best option out there. But what about off-gassing VOCs? What do you need to know? Let's talk about it. So first of all, let's clear a couple things up. What is off-gassing? What are VOCs? Any gas that is trying to escape from a liquid or a solid, that's off-gassing. Gas that's trying to escape either during some sort of change in the process or due to some sort of agitation. Gas trying to escape from a solid or a liquid, that's off-gassing. VOCs are a byproduct of off-gassing. VOC stands for volatile organic compound. Very scary sounding name. Really, that can be a red flag term to a lot of people because they instantly think carcinogenic, this terrible and toxic, and it oftentimes can be. The types of VOCs and the amount of VOCs, that's a crucial thing that you have to keep in mind because we have to understand and accept VOCs are everywhere in the world. You right now watching this, wherever you are surrounded by VOCs. They're just in a safe level. So now let's dive into what off-gassing and VOCs have to do with foam insulation. First of all, let's knock out injection foam because it's very, very quick and easy, especially when we're talking about RetroFoam injection foam. Simply put, it does not off-gas. There is no off-gassing with the RetroFoam product. Now, I will say, of course, barring any sort of weird catastrophic issue between mixing, mechanical, weird anomaly, RetroFoam product, no off-gassing. So therefore, no VOCs. Now let's talk about spray foam. Spray foam, there will be off-gassing. There's no way around it. Now, there are some new products that are coming out that might be a little bit different, but you have to keep in mind, spray foam has to have a propellant. It's pressurized, it's propelled out. Now, there are water-blown materials, there's chemical-blown materials, so the range really is crazy wide when it comes to spray foam as far as the amount of VOCs, what kind of VOCs, and there's all kinds of certifications for products to show you that they're either low VOC or the VOCs that they do emit are healthier and are cleaner. That's been a really big push for spray foam. You have to keep in mind when you're looking at spray foam, comparing it to injection foam, they are really two different animals. Now, yes, they are both foam insulation products and they are technically foam plastic insulation products, but again, they are very far apart on the spectrum. You can kind of compare it to a Saint Bernard and a Pomeranian are both dogs. Very, very different animals though. And spray foam and injection foam are really the same. They're really different animals. So when it comes to spray foam, there will be a level of off-gassing almost every time. But as long as you're using a premium product, it should be safe. And the contractor that's installing it, of course, should be following whatever measures that manufacturer is telling them to make sure they're staying in the safety guidelines for what they spec that product out. As always, I recommend that you make sure you're really vetting your contractors and that you're asking these questions. If you have any concerns about that, if you're using spray foam and you have concerns of VOCs or anything else to do with the product, make sure you're talking to your contractor about that. They should be upfront with that and you should be asking those questions. Now, I do want to take a second and commend you for doing your research, asking these questions, looking up videos like this, because this is the stuff you should be looking into. You should educate yourself as much as possible and ask your contractor all of these questions. So good on you being a smart consumer. Now, with that said, I'm only scratching the surface in this video. These are just the broad strokes, just the information you need to know about this topic. So if you want to learn more about VOCs, off-gassing, foam in general, safety and all that, go to our link below to our Learning Center, where we have all sorts of videos, blogs, and guides talking about everything you need to know about foam insulation. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.